Hey, what's up guys, this is ET Vapor back with another video. Tonight's video is going to be a review of another authentic, affordable device. That device is a CLT RDA by Infinite. That's going to be another pretty quick video, so I'm just going to go ahead and switch the camera around and dive up close to get a better look at the CLT RDA. Alright, so here we are up close guys with the CLT RDA by Infinite. When you first get it, it comes just like this in this pretty decent packaging. It's like a hard cardboard paper type of material. And you just open it up like this. Okay, there's your RDA. It has this little two-sided screwdriver, which I haven't used. Just pop out the RDA just like that. And then right underneath you have a little baggie with some extra parts. You got some O-rings, some silica, and that's it. Okay. And here's the RDA itself. I'm going to throw it on this ohmmeter real quick. Alright. First off, you're going to see in a second, I did not take my previous build out of here for a couple reasons. One, because I'm really enjoying the build, and two, I don't have any 22 gauge wire left, or any wire at all for that matter, so I'm only running this and another RDA right now are my only two builds that I'm vaping on, so I have to order some more wire. Anyways, this RDA also comes with a stainless steel, well first off it's all stainless steel, comes with a pretty decent little drip tip, little wide bore there, sort of wide bore, okay. The top cap right here, another heat sink design, which are getting pretty popular lately with a lot of these RDAs coming out, has sort of a conical shape inside the barrel for flavor, and it has these right here that you can adjust for your airflow just by turning it, just like a lot of these other RDAs as well, okay. Here's the barrel, pretty simple, CLT Infinite, your two slots, your Cyclops style slots for your airflow, okay, pretty simple, really nice, the machining on this is really good. Yeah, the price, it's around $30, $30-$35 bucks on most sites. Again, I got this at vapordna.com. I've been going through them a lot lately. Okay, now, here's my build in here, which, I'll put this back on real quick. It is a 22-gauge G-Plat dual-center macro coil. 8 wraps each side, came out 2.2, or... excuse me, 0.12. And I think that's running somewhere around 28 amps. And I'm always using the, VTC4 batteries. VTC5s are kind of hard, and I suppose they're stopped making them, but I don't know. We'll see. Anyways, be safe, guys, with your batteries. Vape safe. Those are the only batteries I use. Alright, so here's the deck, okay, a four-post design, the two negative posts are milled to the deck, then it has the center block, Phillips head screws, I believe the post holes are something like 2 millimeter, could be a little bit bigger, maybe 2.5 somewhere in that area, I'm not exactly sure on that. So yeah, pretty nice deep juice well there. You stuff a lot of cotton in there, holds a lot of juice, really good. Got the usual two O-rings. And the base, it is a 22mm device, so it'll sit flush on all your 22mm mods. On the bottom here, Infinite CLT 2483. I mentioned last time in the other serial number, the last two numbers were 84, my birth year. And then this one starts out with 24, we're on the 24th, So, and I bought these within like the same week. I thought that was kind of funny. So the 510 or the pin is copper. It is non-adjustable though. All right. So that's pretty much it, guys. Like I said, I got this at vapordna.com for like 30 or 34 bucks. And they do have coupon codes that you could find to always get something off your order. They have fairly fast shipping. And, yeah. So, I'm not going to be re-wicking this or vaping it. Just talking about it like last time. But if you do want to see some vapor production, you can head over to my Instagram at etvapor. And I have a... at least a couple videos or one video while using it. Also, if you have the Mutation X RDA, the barrels are interchangeable. Or at least the Mutation X fits on the CLT deck, which is pretty cool. But yeah, guys, it's really decent. Like I said last time, there's a lot of these authentic devices that are coming out that are affordable. They already have the CLT version 2, which looks pretty much like a Vulcan design. It has the heat sinks on the top and bottom. And also on the version 1 on the Vapor DNA site, they also have it in a black finish, which looks pretty cool. Yeah, man, there's a lot of cool stuff coming out lately. I am going to have some more things come. I'm going to be ordering some more things soon. So, more videos to come. So, you guys just remember to fight the FDA, and just let's keep calm and vape on.